Hi, hi, hi. Hello friends. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Let's continue our course of RRB SSC JEE most important questions. So this is the lecture series of part 3. Okay, so we'll start the question here which we left in the last session. We'll start the question here. 36. The capacitance measured between any two cores of a 3-core cable with sheath earthed is 3 microfarads. The capacitance per phase will be. So here the capacitance measured between any two cables with a third cable is connected to sheath here. The sheath is earthed here like this. So here the capacitance mentioned here like this. Okay, so sheath is earthed here directly. Now they're given that 3 microfarads is a capacitance between the two conductors. Now what they asked here, it is the capacitance per phase. So we know that the formula here. So when the capacitance between two conductor is 3 microfarads, the neutral is, which we already discussed in the previous questions, it is 2 times that of C. So C value is how much? 3. So 2 into 3 is going to be 6 microfarads. So here among the options, B is the right option for this question here. So we'll move to the next question here. And in an insulated cable having a core diameter D, small d, and overall diameter capital D, the ratio of maximum stress to the minimum dielectric stress is given by. So here insulated cable is there which is having a diameter of D. So diameter of D here and capital D here. Okay, now we need to find the maximum, the ratio of G max to the, so G max to G minimum is, okay, so the point here, it is the maximum stress is available on the conductor surface and the minimum stress is available on the outer conductor surface here. Okay, so this one will be capital D by small d here. So maximum stress is at the surface and minimum stress is the outer surface here. Okay, so answer here it is D by D. Next one. Two lossy capacitors with equal capacitances values and the power factor of 0.01 and 0.02 are connected in parallel and the combined is supplied from a sinusoidal voltage source, the power factor of the combination. So here there are two lossy capacitors as like this which are supplied from a sinusoidal voltage source like this. Okay, they are having a power factor of 0.01 and 0.02. Okay, now what we need to find is the power factor of the combination, entire combination. So first of all, so phi 1 is equal to cos inversion of 0.01, so it will be 89.42 degrees, and similarly phi 2 will be 88.85 degrees. So we'll take the average value here. So average phi is equal to, so combination of phi 1 plus phi 2 divided by 2, so which is equal to 89.135. So if you take the power factor cos phi, so this value cos phi here, phi value will be this one, that is going to be 0.015, or simply you can take the average of this 0.01 plus 0.02. If you add this value, you will get this 0.015 is the power factor for this question here. So we'll move to the next question here. If the insulation resistance of 2 meter long sample of a cable is 10 mega ohms, so 2 meters length and 10 mega ohms, then 8 meter length long sample of the same will have an insulation resistance. So insulation resistance is always inversely proportional to its length. So based on this formula, you can write a conclusion that R2 into L2 is equal to R1 L1. So from this, R2 is equal to R1 value is a, how much? So R1 value is 10 mega ohms into meter length is 2 divided by L2 will be how much? So L2 will be 8. So based on this, it is going to be 2.5 mega ohms is the answer. So among the options, B is the right answer here. And the next question, the 40th here, the BOT. So what is the BOT? Board of Trade Unit. So board of trade unit. So the board of trade unit of electrical energy is 1 kilowatt hour. So 1 kilowatt hour C is the right option for this question. Now next question, if the voltage is increased by n times, the size of the conductor will be. Okay, the size of the conductor is given by area of cross section of the conductor, which is proportional to 1 by V square. Okay, so 1 by V square means here, because of this ratio, so if the voltage increased by n times, the size of the conductor decreases by n square times, 1 by n square times. So among the options here, it is D is the right option for this question. So as the voltage increases, the number voltage increases by n times, so cross section area also decreases by n square times here. Okay, next question. So 42nd question here, a wire is placed on top of transmission line. So suppose the transmission line, so here we have a conductors like this. So see, here we have conductors which will carry phase A, phase B like this. On top of the transmission line, so this wire is there, so which is act as a ground wire. The purpose of this wire is to protect the transmission line when a electrical surge occurs, lighting surges. So when the lighting surge occurs, the surge will travel through this path and to the transmission line to the ground. Okay, but not into the transmission line. So these are the transmission lines. So here we have, so this part is transmission lines. Okay, so we'll see the same question again in this session, right? So we'll move to next question. There's a question number 43. So question number 43 here. Okay, next. The conductor by means of which the metal body of an equipment or an application is connected to earth. So suppose if you take any equipment, the metal body of that equipment is connected to the ground here. So with the help of what? Earth continuity conductor. So this is called earth continuity conductor here. So important question. Next one, the question number 44. Which of the following excitation control method is satisfactory? Okay, so the excitation control method is satisfactory only for relative short lines. So short lines period. Okay, however, it is not suitable for long and medium transmission lines. Why? Because in the alternator, excitation supply is there. So which are going to vary this excitation to increase the voltage of the system. Okay, so it is suitable only for short lines. It is not economical for long lines. Okay, so answer is D. Next one, 45. The bundle conductors in EHV transmission system provide. The main effect of bundle conductor in an increase is an increase in the effective radius of the phase conductors. So increases effective radius. So effective radius of the conductor, it will increase here. So radius of the conductor will increase. Okay, effective radius of the conductor. So thereby decreasing the surface. Thereby decreasing the surface of the conductors. So this will reduces the corona. So corona here reduces. Okay, so here in the options they said increase in the corona losses. So this is not the right option. So reduced voltage gradient is a right option for this question. So reduced voltage gradient. Okay, and the next question here, 46. Welding is injurious to eye because of the both infrared radiation and ultraviolet radiations, but UV rays are more danger. So more danger here. So that's the reason why. So both are correct. Answer is the right option. Next one, the highest transmission AC voltage in India. So it is 400 kV is the highest transmission in India. Now we are following, right? Next one, the 48th question. The power distribution by a cable is generally adopted of the line when the line length is less than 10 kilometers. Line is kilometers. Next one, the leakage resistance of 50 kilometer long cable is 1 mega ohm. For 100 kilometer long cable, it will be dash. So a similar kind of problem we solved in this session. So I am writing the answer. So for this problem, the answer will be 0.05 mega ohms. So that's it, friends. This for this session. We will continue in the next session. If you like my video, please subscribe, share, and comment. Thank you.